Okay, so in this video we will discuss about the differences between the configurational and conformational isomers. So first we have to consider the origin of these two types of isomers. So for that we have to go into the stereoisomers and its categories, different types of stereoisomers. So stereoisomers are basically of two types, enantiomers and diastereomers. So if there are two isomers which possess a mirror image relationship with each other, then they are enantiomers. We all know that, right? And if there is no mirror image relationship between two stereoisomers, then they are called the diastereomers. Now is the interesting point. Suppose consider we have two enantiomers, two stereoisomers. Each of them is enantiomer with respect to the other stereoisomer. So now if there is a chance of if you consider the chance of interconversion between those isomers, and if you consider the energy barriers for that conversion, interconversion, then there originates two categories. So if the interconversion is if the interconversion process requires less energy, that is the energy barrier of the interconversion is very low, then those stereoisomers or those enantiomers are called conformational enantiomers, this one. And if the energy barrier is very high, then those are called configurational enantiomers. Don't worry, I will give proper examples for each cases. So first we have to I will give you the diagram or a basic idea, then I will go into the example and the understanding part. Okay, so enantiomers are of two categories, configurational and conformational. In the same way, diastereomers are also of two types, configurational and conformational. Configurational are those which has high energy barrier of the interconversion, and conformational diastereomers are those which has low energy barrier of interconversion. So now let us go through the examples. So first we will discuss the configurational enantiomers. Okay, we have two molecules here, this one and this one. We can clearly see that they are mirror images to each other, but they are not superimposable. If you try to superimpose this molecule to this molecule, then you will be not successful in doing so. Okay, and the absolute configuration of this molecule is R, whereas the absolute configuration for that molecule is S. So in this situation, if you simple rotation is not a way to interconvert between these two molecules. Okay, so what can be done to interconvert these two molecules? The only way to interconvert these two molecules is the breaking of sigma bond. Suppose you break this bromine carbon bond and put this bromine atom from here to this position, and interchange this chlorine atom from this position to that position, then you will get this molecule. After interconversion, if you rotate the molecule, then you can clearly see that you are getting this molecule. So only option is the breaking of a sigma bond in order to interconvert between these two isomers. So that's why you all know that the breaking of a sigma bond requires very high energy, and for this reason, for this high energy barrier restriction, this is an example of configurational enantiomers. So after that, if you consider a configurational diastereomer situation, we have two molecules, this one and this one. So these two molecules are not having any mirror image relationship with each other. Obviously there will be no superimposable condition after taking the mirror image. So these two are the diastereomers. The absolute configurations are given here. You can check the absolute configuration by assigning the priority rules. This is 1, this whole part is 2, and this is 3. The hydrogen atom is below the plane, so 1, 2, 3 clockwise rotation, it is R. In this fashion, all the stereo centers are designated with absolute configurations. So these two diastereomers are also interconvertible via sigma bond cleavage. Okay, so if you break this OH bond, and there is also a hydrogen below the plane, if you interchange this hydrogen and this OH groups, then you can attain this molecule, and this can be done only via breaking of two sigma bonds. So this is a highly energy consuming process, so that's why these two are configurational diastereomers. Okay, so now we will look into conformational enantiomers. So these two, look at this. Okay, so what is the criteria for this conformational enantiomers? The energy barrier will be very low, must be very low. Okay, so these two molecules are enantiomers to each other. They are mirror images to each other, and they are also superimposable. So how to check that whether they are superimposable or not? Simple, just rotate this molecule around this axis. ₹120 rotation have to be done, then you will get this molecule, then you will get this orientation of the methyl will be there. And this methyl will go in this position, here to here, and this methyl will go from here to here, so it will be in this position. Sorry, it will be in this position. Okay, so you can clearly see that these two are not superimposable, non-superimposable mirror images. Right, but we can interconvert. These two enantiomer. So we have just checked that these two are enantiomers. How to check that? We have to just take. We have just to check that if there is any mirror image relationship, which they has, and they are not superimposable to each other. Okay, so they are not. So they are enantiomers. So we have to check whether they are interconvertible in very low temperature, that is in room temperature. So for that we have to do this thing. Just perform a ring flip. This methyl is in the up, that is the axial position, and up, so it will remain up but in equatorial position. And this methyl was in also in up, so this will also remain in the up position, but it will go in the axial position. Right, so now if you rotate this molecule 120 degree, along this axis, this methyl will go in this position, and this methyl will go in this position. Right? So this molecule and this molecule, they are same, right? So they can be interchanged, they can be interconvertible via simple ring flip and rotation along the axis, which requires very less amount of energy. That's why it is called conformational enantiomers, right? So now we will look into the conformational diastereomer also. Okay, so these two molecules are diastereomer. How you will say that these are diastereomer? Because this molecule has a sigma plane. This is not chiral, so there is no criteria that if a molecule is not chiral, then it cannot be it cannot possess any diastereomeric relationship with any other molecule, right? Because the definition of diastereomer is what? If a molecule possesses a non-superimposable mirror image with another molecule, then they are called diastereomer. So this molecule and this molecule, clearly they are not mirror images to each other, and also they are not superimposable. So that's why they are diastereomers. So now we have to check whether they are interconvertible via simple low energy consuming transformations. So for that we have to perform a ring flip. That chlorine atom which was in the down position in equatorial will also remain in the down position, but this time it will be in the axial position. So we can see now that these two molecules are same. So it is an example of conformational diastereomer. Okay, so clear. Thank you for watching this video. I hope that I have helped you guys to understand these different concepts of conformational and configurational stereoisomers. Okay, see you next.